Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a weekly food planner. This includes all of your meals that you plan for the week and also your shopping list. So the first thing I want to do is actually turn this page around to landscape. So go up to layout and along to orientation, click on the drop down and select landscape. And then whilst we're on layout, I'm going to go to margins, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select a narrow margin to enable us to use as much space on the page as possible. So the first thing is to insert a table. So go to insert, table, click on the drop down, and I want 4 columns and 8 rows because I need a title row as well. So once you've inserted your table, select it. I'm going to customize it first and then I'm going to copy it for the shopping list. So select the table. Go up to layout, go to height, and in here I'm going to change the height just to give you a little bit more space to type to 0.75 and press enter. That just extends the height of those cells just to allow us a little bit more space. And at the moment, if I type, I'm going to type at the top of the cell. So you obviously can write on this and print it out if you want to, but you can also type in it. So I'm going to select the whole table, go up to layout, and I'm going to select center left. So now when I type, my words will be in the center and to the left. What I also want to do is customize my font. So I'm going to select the table, go to home, go to the fonts, and I'm going to select this one here. And then all I'm going to do is select the table, go to home, go to copy, and then if I put my cursor in the top left up here and just press the return key twice, put my cursor back to the top left and then press paste, I'm going to have another table that's exactly the same. So it'll have exactly the same font and I've also extended the heights of those rows. I'm going to press my return key again, my cursor's in the top left, and that will allow us just to push that down. So what I need to do now, I'm going to ensure that we've got enough space for a title, but to maximize these rows here to enable us to put as much in our shopping list as possible. We've got the 7 days and title down here, which I'll put the text in a second. Just go along to this bottom right row, press the tab key, move the cursor again to bottom right and tab, and I'm going to continue to do that until I knock, there we go, we knock it over to the second page so we know that's too much. Or we can just go over to the ruler. If you can't see your rulers, go to view and make sure rulers are checked. Just hover your cursor between the white and grey section, you'll see it'll change. Click and drag that down and that will just reduce that margin a little bit to give you a little bit of extra space. You can do it with the top as well over here. If you wanted to move the top up, you can do that as well. So now I'm just going to move this column here because I want to put some numbers down the side here for my days of the week. So hover your cursor over this line and just pull that over to the left. There we go. I'm just going to put my numbers in. There we go. And then I want to make sure that all of these columns here are equal. So select just those 3 columns, go to layout, and go to distribute columns. Then I'm just going to input my text. For these texts, these titles, I'm just going to put them into the center. So select this row, and I'm going to go up to this icon here, align to center. And then we can put in our meals. And then again at the top here, we can merge this row here. So we can put a title in the top here. You don't have to, but you can if you want to. Select the row, go to layout, and click on merge cells. And again, I'm going to go up to center, and then I'm going to put my title up here, which is shopping list. And then I could put a title up here at the top and put it to the center and type the title up here, but I'm not going to because the particular text I want to use, and I'll demonstrate this to you. So if we put in weekly meal planner, and let's say I wanted to alter this text to the one I want. So if I click on the drop down, I want to select this particular font here, which is Bellania. Now this is a free font from a website. And if you need to see that video of how to import fonts, then I'll leave that in the link below. So click on that one. And as you can see, automatically that font has pushed down the tables and it's actually still quite small. So if I wanted to make this a little bit bigger, so if I went over to the Home tab and went over to the Increase Font Size tool here, if I was to click on this, what you have is quite a distance. Even if I move this table up, so let's move this table up. To make that title quite big, we haven't got any space above it, but I would want that text to be quite big, probably about there. I'm going to have to take out some rows here, but I've actually got quite a bit of space at the top and the bottom here, but I can't control any of that. So I'm going to use a text box, and I'll show you why I would use a text box. So I'm going to copy this title, Command or Control C, and then just delete it. And then I'm just going to go back to this icon here that says clear all formatting. And then just because it's cleared the formatting, it's taken out that large font cursor that we had. And my font's over to the left here. So I'm just going to press the return key a few times. That's it, it was too many. And go to insert, text box, click on the drop down and select draw text box. And then whilst my cursor's in the text box, I'm going to press Command or Control V, which is to paste. And you can see my title's in here. Now, this title in this text box has a white background and a black border. And we don't want either of them. I mean, you can keep them if you want to, but I don't want either of those. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline and select No Outline. Go to Shape Fill, click on the drop-down and select No Fill. And now you can see it's completely transparent. Now the other thing to note is normally if you type into a text box, your font will be over to the left. So to change that, just go to the Home tab and select this center alignment tool here and it will center it in the middle. Now what this does allow me to do now is if I want to increase the size of this text, you can see it doesn't adjust my tables. So it has no effect on the tables if I want to increase or decrease the size of this text. I can also move it down so it can sit on the line if I want to. I can move it up as high as I want to. So I can really capitalize on the space that I've been given at the top here. Now, if I want to make this smaller and increase the amount of rows that I want, then I can do that as well. It just means that this gives you a little bit more versatility. So I'm going to go to Shape Format and I'm going to use the Alignment tool, click on the drop down and make sure that it's aligned to the center. Okay, if you don't see Shape Format, it's because you haven't selected your text box. I'm going to add some color into this top row here and here. And then I'm just going to put a date in the footers and then we're nearly done. So let's select this cell here, go to Table Design and go to Shading, click on the drop down. You can select from any of these colors. If you don't see with the color of your choice, go to More Colors. You have a color wheel here. You can move the cursor around. You can also use the brighten and darken slider as well. And whatever color you choose will be in this square here. And then just click OK. But for this one, I've already selected my pink color. So select that one. And then over to here, I'm just going to select that row. And again, put some pink shading in there. Again, completely your choice. You can put in whatever colors you want. And now to the bottom, if I double click down at the bottom here, you can see I go into the footer. Now don't worry too much about the fact that the last row has jumped over. We'll sort that out in a second. Now again, if I type here, I've got no choice. I can use my return key and then type on the next row down, but you can see how that adjusted the footer. So again, we're not given as much flexibility as we want or I want. So again, I'm going to use a text box. So go to Insert, Text Box, Draw Text Box, click and draw out a text box. And then I'm just going to type week beginning. And then I'm just going to simply put a lot of full stops just to give that dotted line. We could put a line in, but it just makes things a little bit more complicated. This is just a very quick meal planner. So again, this has got a borderline and a background. We'll get rid of that. So select it, Shape Format. Now, because we've already selected No Outline, it's already there. So you just need to click on it. And again, for this one, just click on it and it will disappear. And then what this will allow us to do is put this anywhere we like, giving us that added flexibility. Now, what I will do is just zoom in, is to make sure that the W lines up with the edge of this table. So I'm just going to select the table. Sorry, my cursor's inside there. Select the table, use my arrow key, just move that over to the left. And then I just might move that down just a little bit, putting it in the center between the bottom line here and the bottom of the page. Okay, so to get out of the headers and footers, just double click into the main body of your document. And you can see the 7 has now jumped over to this part here, or to the second page. So let's go over to our rulers again, and let's go to the top one, and let's just pull that margin up slightly. And once that, there we go, and then just move this down. Let's just pop that back into the center. Perfect. So once you've finished it, the best thing to do is to save this as a template, and then you can use it time and time again. So even if you fill it all out and you save it, you'll be saving it as a brand new document, and the original will be saved just as it is now. So go to File, Save as Template. You can save it as shopping list or whatever you want. Make sure you save it to templates. That's really important. And make sure your file format is Microsoft Word Template. If you can't find it, you may find it in the drop down. Once you're happy, click save, and you can see this is currently shopping list. So now if I open a new document, here's templates at the top, go over to the right and click on more templates. You can see at the top here, I've got all my personal templates, it says personal here. Click on the shopping list, click create, and as you can see, we've now got document 3. It's not called shopping list, it's a brand new document. So now if I was to type, let's put toast in for breakfast, and now if I'm going to click save, it will actually ask me to save it as a totally new document. So then your original one is saved in your templates. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.